electric fields. The first question is, does zeta potential depend on applied electric field? Experimentally, I have seen that when I change the applied field, zeta changes. Why? Yes, it does, under certain conditions. Here are some data from my next generation electrophoretic light scattering system that show this very well. You can see that both the electrode voltage and the frequency have an influence. The more you increase the voltage and or the frequency, the greater the measured electrophoretic mobility. Why? Recall what I said about the effect of double layers at the electrodes and how they cause the electric field in the bulk sample to be less than the instrument assumes based on the externally generated voltage or current. There's a potential drop between the electrode and the sample. This is independent of the applied voltage. It's like an activation energy. This diagram shows a DC voltage being applied, but in practice, an AC voltage is applied, sometimes a square wave, sometimes a sine wave, which means the field reverses and the double layers keep reforming. This resembles charging and discharging a capacitor, which leads to a frequency dependence of the underestimation of mobility as well as a voltage dependence. Commercial instruments are limited to the frequency range that they can use, and each instrument uses a different frequency that is often unknown to the user. Unfortunately, their limited range is the very range where the greatest sensitivity to frequency is. It's quite easy to try to recover the true mobility. Measure mobility at a few voltages and plot the product of the measured mobility and applied voltage versus the applied voltage. The gradient will be the true mobility. You must understand that the error is both sample and vendor specific. Electrolyte concentration affects the polarization of the electrodes. Applied voltages or currents and frequencies are very dependent on the particular instrument and also the design of the electrodes themselves. This is why you have to be very cautious when comparing high salt concentration samples on different instruments. Question: if you work at 4 molar aqueous potassium chloride, how will you avoid joule heating? The first thing is to reduce the average current flowing through the sample, but at the same time, maintain the same field strength. It sounds impossible. Yes, if you keep the field on all the time, but you can apply the field for, say, one cycle and collect data during that period. Then turn the field off for the equivalent of, say, 10 cycles. It requires high field frequencies, though, at least an order of magnitude higher than commercial instruments can generate. And of course, very effective sample cell cooling.